by the CEPI, the Scientific and Technological Cooperation of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, and he has been responsible of the informatics service at National Neurological Institute C. Besta of Milano. His activity consists on studies and design of health information system, computerization of medical record and clinical databases, statistical softwares, and applications of artificial intelligence techniques in biomedicine. He is an author of more than 350 national and international publications in medical informatics, telemedicine, and software for data analysis. He is, it is very important, responsible of several research projects on medical informatics and telemedicine of Italian, European, and international R&ID programs. Now, I yield the floor to Professor Sicurelli.
Thank you very much, Chairman. I want to thank you, and in particular, I want to thank Professor Ali and Professor Salem Badi for the invitation to this interesting conference here in for me the first time in Georgia. One of the most important fields of application of IT before and now ICT for telecommunication development the last 20-25 years is the medicine field, or in general the healthcare sector. Because in this field, medicine, biomedicine, and health organization, we are in front of a lot of data coming from genetic cell research, coming from clinical practice, coming from population. We speak in particular of genetic, medicine, and epidemiology. In this different field of the medicine, we have a lot of information and data to apply, to manage, to process, to analyze, to understand, in order to support better the activity of the doctors, of the physicians. In particular now, for we are in the presence of the increase of the population, of the aging of the population. And this is very important because a lot of the chronic diseases grow up for these people, in particular diabetes, cardiovascular disease, neurological disease, cancer, and we have different subfields in medicine. And in particular, now the needs, the asking for the citizen to receive more information using the ICT technology. Because it's very important to inform, to give the news, the better and the care to the population, and they ask for more information in order to change from this hospital to another hospital, from this doctor to another. Another is to share the information, to share the knowledge in medicine. IT in the past and now ICT are precious technologies to support this circulation of knowledge in the and the data in the medical sector. Moreover, the medicine, the healthcare is a business sector for the society due to the globalization. Even in this sector, it is a market, and the demands for more qualified health services for the citizens, in particular in the developing countries. These are some aspects in different countries, around 10% of gross product is necessary to, for budget and for maintain the health sector. Now the problem is to reduce the costs. Even in this sector, the problem is to contain the cost, but the other hand to enlarge the services to the other people. Poor or rich people, the people want to stay well and ask for better services in healthcare. Maybe we IT and ICT are correct. If this technology are correctly used, can support well the this change of the paradigm in, even in the health sector. The problem is to link different levels of health structures, from general practitioner to university hospitals. In order to avoid, to repeat examination and to increase data, because it's possible to ask, to assess at different levels to databases where the information of the patient stay, and to avoid other complicated examination. Sometimes is very difficult examination, like X-ray or magnetic resonance or other. Network is very important. Networking in the healthcare using the IT and the IT for to create before the information system inside the hospital, and after connect different hospitals, different health districts, different health structure using telecommunication. Sharing information, sharing database, ICT and telemedicine can contribute to these challenges, to improving the level of health maintenance and to reduce the costs. This is another economical. The ICT market is growing, in particular in the last 10 years. It's about 5-8% of the budget in health sector. After the pharmaceutical budget and the medical image. Here is the second. No, maybe it's similar to medical image in we need in the integration some standards, of course. And we have H level 7, Health level 7 is a standard ANSI to generate interoperability between database and information system. And we have another important standard for image communication, digital imaging and communication in healthcare. E-Health is, before mentioned by the last speaker, is an important application of ICT technologies now. For these three aspects, to access better by mobile, by connection, we use the mobile health, to access very quickly to the care services, using telemedicine, teleconsultation, even from home for elder people. To maintain the quality of care with continuous education, image assisted by computers, electronic prescription, and to reduce the cost with economic economy of care. This is three aspects very important of the European Union in the next year program 2000. Horizon 2020. The focus is the evolution of the IT. I remember many years ago we used the IT inside the hospital to create small or large databases. The focus is to create a database starting from electronic patient record. This is the first step. Collect data one time, not different times, in a admission point of the care, for example, in hospital, during the admission and discharge of the patient, and collect this in electronic patient record, using a different technology. Link this record between inside or outside the hospital, creating the intra or extra net in hospital for different tasks to support the clinical practice, to support the evaluation of the research, to support the epidemiological studies, and integrating this record in the network for telemedicine. Telemedicine is a very, very important element. I speak very quickly about this system. Of course, internet. We, before Professor said this, internet is used in, is popular, is de facto standard, is important even in healthcare to create website portals in order to diffuse protocols of care. And in this way, professionals and doctors in a remote area can use the same protocol of the university hospital. For example, in epilepsy pregnancy, we studied in the Institute of Neurology this protocol, how to help the woman pregnant during an attack of epilepsy. It's very important to know the protocol of care for the general practitioner or for the nurses. They can find this protocol in a website of our institute, for example, in Italy, or different institute of neurology in other countries. What is telemedicine? It's a subpart of here. Medicine at a distance, we have a different definition, in particular telemedicine is this convergence. We have a definition of the Institute of Medicine in USA many years ago, about 17 years ago, to assess better using the technology of communication for to provide the support to healthcare when the distance is a problem. Or this is a more correct definition of the WHO in the Geneva at the end of the last century, is the delivery of healthcare services. A critical factor of the distance, using information and communication technology, using IT and communication, of course. For exchange information, correct information, to support for the diagnosis, telemedicine is very useful in diagnostic process, not in therapy, in diagnostic process. In psychology, psychiatric, is used telemedicine for therapy at a distance, because last year in the New York Times described the system of teletherapy in psychological disease and the prevention of disease. Even education, continuous education. We have different activities, telediagnosis, teleconsulting, telemonitoring. Telemonitoring is some software developed to interface devices on the body of the patient during the acquiring the some vital data, for example, in cardiology, in diabetes, for telemonitor and tele surveillance the people with the chronic disease, even during the normal life, at home or in the world, or of course in telemedicine. It's very important in telemedicine, in half an hour, in 1 hour, receive the correct data in the first day when arrive the ambulance to the hospital. The main application field of the medicine are cardiology, the most historical. Now the radiology, but we need a broadband in order to transmit in the network, transmit in a few small time a lot of quantity of images. In pathology, in ophthalmology, in dermatology, of course, in psychiatry, and so on. This is a system for telecardiology, for radiology, it's more complex, because we must acquire DICOM image from the modality, from magnetic resonance, from disease, cardiac, and so on. A pathology is very easy. And the cost is very, very, this is a system in Cairo, in the Italian hospital of Cairo, very microscope, camera, and computer. Acquire the image, JPEG in this case, image of the the glass, histopathologic glass, and send immediately to another center, another service, another hospital in order to receive a better consultant, a better reference. It's very, sometimes we use satellite communication between country in sub-Saharan Africa and Europe. This is a type of pathology. Another important application of IT software is intelligence. But we need interface using particular software, the database, the computer with the device, a lot of devices, bio devices for diabetes, for glucose level measurement, for ACG, for electrocardiogram, for retina images. We have a lot of devices, and the problem of informatics is to connect very well in physical and software programs these different devices. We have a lot of digital ACG. The evolution is very, very quickly this is ACG with memory, continuous memory. It's another application of ECG using cellular, before PDA system, now smartphone, no problem. For oxygen saturation in the body, and so on, This is for monitoring for the glucose. All this in our institute, in a cooperation with another Polytechnic in Milan, they created this edition with the biosensors for people with disabilities. Because the problem to measure the ACG is to stay quiet, but sometimes the disabled people have the problem of movement, and they use this t-shirt for monitoring some vital data, medical data, in particular the rate, the pressure, and the ACG. This device. The bio device is in evolution, even in radiological. Okay, very quickly, I show you some our projects. But wireless system is very important in our field of application in medicine, and we need the good and correct. professor says about GPRS, Wi-Fi, WiMAX. In our cooperation between Europe and other countries, Italy, we develop a health network in order to connect the services and to spread the information to several structures and to create this interoperability and cooperation between professionals and the researchers. The aims of our cooperation is to create a database and coordinate the policy of the Department of Major Disease as cancer, in particular, cancer and other diseases. We connect in our project for Mediterranean area different research institutes. During my stage in the Institute of Neurology in Milano, I was the IT manager during 5-6 years ago I finished. We received the financement from the European Commission for the NeuroWeb. NeuroWeb and T-Care, and now we waiting for diabetes care and the other projects. NeuroWeb is where is a very important project in order to integrate a different level in the four neurological institutions in Italy, in Hungary, in Patras, Greece, and Rotterdam. Yes, Rotterdam. To integrate a clinical database. Inside to integrate in the same database genomic data in order to study the genotype phenotype correlation and knowledge base. In this schema, you can see not all, but a great part of the IT knowledge for me, for you, because we use ontology, we use query language, we use different application for integration and analyze the data of the expert system, given the knowledge base. This is was a big 2 million of euros in 3 years, and now we finished this project applied only in the ictus stroke disease in order to understand better the risk and the cause of stroke disease in Europe. Different tools, open source, UML, Java, XML is another standard, and the different tools coming from the IT studies and IT researchers. For communication, this is very new project in Italy using the digital TV. We have digital TV in every region, in each region, and it's possible to transform the television using a particular set-top box with the HS, security HS and smart card to collect from the at home using particular devices some data for the diabetes, for example, and to transmit this data in a web server to the hospital and receive the correct referral, and sometimes with the channel, change the channel, particular dedicated channel, you receive news. The patient, the citizen can receive some news about the lifestyle, the diet, and now this information you can receive in mHealth in your smartphone. It's possible to follow, to receive some indication in order to eat or not eat this food, the weight. It's very important indication for the for the center of the diabetology center. It's possible to migrate this TV to web TV. This is only technology that you use now in a web television. A subsystem is to a consequence of diabetes is the consequence of diabetes other many diseases in the heart, in nephrology, but one of the consequences, big consequence of the diabetes disease is diabetic retinopathy, the possibility to lose the vision in during the evolution of the diabetes. We developed in not in my university, in another university of Como University, this system in order to acquire and transmit image of the retina using this retinography on the internet. It's not difficult to use, it's possible to use even in at the office of the general practitioner or in the center of the diabetology without the ophthalmologist, and acquire the image of the retina. This is the image normal and retinopathy is on the right, and transmit using this retinography, transmit to the data image, database of images in the hospital where the ophthalmologist can give the correct reference. And monitoring every month, over 2 months, the retina is possible to understand when it's possible to create a therapy correct for this stage of loss vision. It's very important because it's possible now to receive the correct therapy with the drugs or with the laser therapy or with the injection inside the eye. Another project is to connect two hospitals in Italy and in Romania. We extend this to Balkan area, not in Serbia, but in Croatia, in Albania. This is similar for radiology, cardiology, and Hungary, of course, this is Balkan area. And the last is this project for Mediterranean area, the same. We created this portal for intramed portal, in the Mediterranean. So, this is another sub-project linking to different pathology is very important for cancer support, and we use this technology for creating a new network work for the cancer registry in the study. Integrating with the IT information, clinical, genetic, and environmental, and using telepathology to support the this technology and this pathology for support the surgery, the surgery in cancer disease. This project extended in Africa, and we need better telecommunication, satellite communication. In conclusion, we use satellite technology and a geographical information system, and this is the sample. And now, grid and computing technology. For grid technology, experience in Italy for mammography analysis and sharing information about mammography. And the cloud computing, the first speaker spoke about cloud computing is very well. is the future. In our application, the problem is this. Cloud computing in healthcare. We have a different aspect. Technological aspect, hybrid, private. Security aspect, because the health data is very sensible. And some legal aspect, but cloud computing is good, is important if we solve in medicine, in health, this aspect of the security and in order to maintain the privacy of the information of this particular data, sensible for each one of us. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Sikorawa. I hope that you will grow your research on Serbia Research School. And now, have you any questions?
I don't know. Maybe she needs my.
Thank you very much for this interesting lecture about the telemedicine. I want to ask you a question. What are the top three current uses of the telemedicine, do you think? The top three current uses of telemedicine. Top three current uses of telemedicine. The top three. You say many
uses
about telemedicine. I want to know.
The top three projects, the three fields. The top three. First, for the needs of the medicine doctors, pathology, telepathology to support the cancer. For example, we support with the low cost the service cancer for women in distance hospitals without pathologists. They prepare the histopathological glass, take picture of this preparate and send images to our center where two or three pathologists in 24 hours, not in weeks, in one day, replay the correct information about the study of the cancer. And the surgeon can decide how to cut or not cut. This is the first. The second is teleradiology. Radiology is very important. With the cloud and to share imaging, in particular imaging invasive examination. Because the problem is to avoid the patient to do different examination using gamma or X-ray. Teleradiology, and the third, of course, is in telemedicine is telecare, tele-on-care for the monitoring chronic disease, in particular diabetes and related diseases.
First of all, thank you for the interesting presentation. I have two things. The first one is a comment. I think there's a problem with using this project as well. First one is the hardware price. Each patient will have to have his hardware in his home, for example, to check any wrong thing in his body. The second thing is the knowledge of the patient. We can't apply this project for all communities because maybe, for example, somewhere here in the Middle East, most of the people don't know how to use the computer. So you can't push them directly to use this project. This is the problem that you may face. The question is, you mentioned that in teleradiology there's a, it's very complex. In teleradiology, you mentioned that it's complex for transferring images. So, where's the complexity exactly? Is it in the huge amount of data that you transfer? If that is the problem, I knew that there's many techniques used to, for example, extract the important features, for example, or just reduce the size of the images, such as principal component analysis, where we transform, many transforms. I need to know where is the exact complexity in using teleradiology.
Yes. The second question. The complexity is two kinds of complexity in teleradiology. The first is the network in the transmission, because we need high DSL in order to, in a short time, in a short time to send a volume of images very high.
It's
the other complexity depends on the compression of image. We need to compress this image. We're using the software, dedicated software, and the decom, and use the software in order to decompress. And sometimes the doctor will receive the image, ask for quality of the image in order to give the consult. This is the complexity. Physical and with the broadband is possible to reduce this problem and use the correct algorithm for to compress and uncompress. The first question is about the knowledge, yes, in our experience, we monitor 100 elderly people at home, and the problem is the knowledge of this system. We reduce the technology at home, using only the black box, the device, it's very simple devices. Some person with diabetes now use this device very, very quickly. Put the result connected with, like USB with the black box and with the command send this data collected by the device to our services and the specialist read the data after one day and send the information. The education to know very well the computer and the smartphone is very important. But this project you see for next 10 years, the new elder people will be us.
There is one question here, and then
Sorry, Ali. Hi, thank you very much. Yes, actually, I like the presentation, I like the projects actually, because it's very close to our work. But I was thinking, I didn't see in these projects the problem of the traceability. The traceability of using the usage item as an example, the equipment, errors happen, so we need to have some trust about the use of these equipment in the tele systems or using, if something happens, we need to trace all the actions happen, the trace.
The trace.
The trace, sorry, it's in French, sorry, the trace. So. Yes. Yes, we need to know that the trace problems, how you handle these things in these projects.
Which projects?
In the projects that you presented in your work.
Not in the program, in the other project.
In the other project, yes.
Maybe to discuss.
Yes.
Okay, maybe to discuss now after the.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you for very fruitful discussion.
Assalamu alaikum and good afternoon, everybody. Let me introduce our next keynote speaker, Prof. Badia Salem. He is a lecturer in Ain Shams University, Egypt. His main research area is artificial intelligence. He was a research visitor to many worldwide universities. He also has a lot of national and international activities varying from coordination to managerial positions. He also a member of several associations, national and international. His publication exceed 250 papers in international journals and conferences. Finally, he supervised about 16 PhD and master students. Without any further delay, let me introduce our keynote speaker, Prof. Badia Salem. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. My talk is about
machine learning is a subset, subfield from the artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is science and technology. Science, it's interdisciplinary science. It's, you can find computer science, linguistics, biology, psychology, philosophy, mathematics, and engineering. These disciplines equivalent artificial intelligence as a science. As a technology, we are developing intelligent systems. We have expert systems for solving problems in any domain. We have machine vision systems. We have natural language processing. Natural language processing. The machine that can talk with your natural language. Robotics, tutoring systems, again, and this is technology. As a research, we have a lot of research. We have action and perception, reasoning technologies or reasoning techniques. We have a lot of reasoning techniques, automated reasoning, case-based reasoning, non-normal reasoning, member of reasoning. We have a lot of techniques of reasoning. We have connectionist models, neural networks, machine learning, software, knowledge engineering, knowledge engineering, knowledge-based systems. We have a lot of areas of research. And there is a big conference in artificial intelligence. This conference held every 2 years. The number of participants of artificial intelligence conference is each time about 4,000 participants. 4,000 in March. Now we have sub conferences from this. We have now artificial intelligence in law, artificial intelligence in education, artificial intelligence in medicine. And about the machine learning, as I told, machine learning is a subset from the AI. Machine learning is the study of computer algorithms to improve automatically through experience. This slide shows the inherently interdisciplinary field of machine learning. We have information theory, statistics, control theory, artificial intelligence, vision, mathematical methods, psychology, philosophy, neurobiology. This is the influence of these topics of machine learning. We have techniques. We have techniques. We have a lot of techniques, visualization techniques, neural computing or neural networks, inductive logic programming, association rule, fuzzy logic, decision trees, hosting, genetic algorithms, case-based reasoning, swarm intelligence, rough sets. This is the techniques. About the applications, we have a lot of applications. Machine learning exists already, includes systems that analyze past sales data to predict customer behaviors, optimize robot behavior so that the task can be completed with using minimum resources, extract knowledge from medical and biological data. About cancer informatics, cancer informatics is a subset from medical informatics. But the medical informatics and now cancer informatics, using the computer science, artificial intelligence to solve the cancer problems. Also, cancer informatics is defined as a multidisciplinary field of research. We have medical sciences, pathology, oncology, radiology. We have physical chemistry, in addition to the artificial intelligence, computer science, machine learning, and data mining. This is the first example for first machine learning techniques, which is
case-based visioning. Case-based visioning, a machine learning technique. We use it in my research group, my faculty.